गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय सर डॉक्टर सुमित गोयल, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन रेडिएशन ऑन्कोलॉजी, महात्मा गांधी मेडिकल कॉलेज, SRCC, जयपुर. नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यू ट्रायल व्हिच इज पब्लिश्ड इन द पेपर एज ए रैपिडो ट्रायल. इज इट ए न्यू नॉर्मल फॉर लोकली एडवांस्ड रेक्टल कैंसर? विल सी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इन 2020 लैंसेट ऑन्कोलॉजी दैट पब्लिश द पेपर दैट इज शॉर्ट कोर्स रेडियोथेरेपी फॉलोड बाई कीमोथेरेपी एंड TME वर्सेज प्री ऑपरेटिव कीमोथेरेपी. What is the, there is a two arm study that is short course radiotherapy 5x5 gray followed by 6 cycle of chemotherapy and then TME. Another arm that is rapido, that is all preoperative therapy, that is capecitabine based chemo radiation followed by total mesorectal resection then followed by the chemotherapy. The results in the shorts: median survival follow-up was 4.6 years. The cumulative probability of disease-related treatment failure was 23% in the experimental arm and versus 30% in the standard care arm. Now, issues about the local control, metastasis rate, organ preservation and optimal sequencing. The sandwich therapy, that is we can give this short course radiotherapy or long course followed by surgery and followed by adjuvant therapy. Now the total new adjuvant therapy, we can give first of all chemotherapy, then radiotherapy, then surgery, or first of all give radiotherapy, short course, long course, followed by chemo and then surgery. We have to first of all do the staging of the workup, and the based on the Dutch M1 trials, there is a decreased number of distant metastases without increasing the risk of local regional failure, ultimately improving survival outcome. The Dutch protocol was this much, and they have shown that there is a 2-year overall survival was 80% and 2-year recurrence rate was 64% after R0 resection. The primary endpoint was disease-related treatment failure at 3 years. Secondary endpoint was completion rate of new adjuvant treatment, toxicity, R0 resection, pathological complete response or surgical complication within 30 days. This RAPIDO trial is a phase 3 trial, multicentric. The period was from 2011-2016. Total number of patients enrolled was 920, experimental group 460, and standard of care 450. The inclusion criteria was 18 year and older, biopsy proven, newly diagnosed, primary locally advanced rectal adenocarcinoma, distal extension less than 16 cm from anal verge, pelvic MRI, which confirmed this clinical stage, T4A or T4B, and extramural vascular invasion. What are the exclusion criteria? Extensive growth of rectal tumor into the cranial part of the sacrum or the lumbosacral nerve root and presence of metastatic disease. If we see the clinical inclusion criteria, there is a clinical tumor CT4A, T4B, extramural vascular invasion, nodal stage CN2, involved mesorectal fascia, enlarged lateral lymph nodes. Experimental arm was 5 grain, 5 fraction, maximum 8 days. We give the radiotherapy, the followed by the 6 cycle of Capox or 9 cycle of FOLFOX4, followed by of 2 to 4 weeks delay and then dedicated surgery or total mesorectal excision. Standard arm, new adjuvant radiotherapy, either in the form of 50 gray in 25 fraction or 50.4 in 28 fraction with concurrent oral capecitabine, followed by surgery after 6 to 8 weeks and then adjuvant chemotherapy. Chemotherapy was similar in the both arm, that is Capox and FOLFOX. And radiotherapy arm was in the standard arm, they were given 1.8 fraction or either 2 gray fractions. And the target volume was the grossed out disease. We include the entire mesorectum with primary tumor and relevant regional lymph nodes. Surgical procedure, surgery was done according to TME principle. A partial mesorectal excision was accepted for proximal tumors. Open and laparoscopic approaches were allowed and the surgery discussion at the surgeon. Pathological assessment was done and CRM, that is circumferential resection margin involvement, was assessed. And that is follow-up was at clinical assessment was done at the 6, 12, 24, 36, 60 month after surgery, including CME, CEA measurement, there is chest X-ray or CT thorax, total colposcopy was done, on indication other diagnostic procedures were allowed. Statistics, that is, was done by intent to treat analysis, comparison by Kaplan-Meier, baseline characteristic, if we see both groups are equally matched in all the characteristics, our result. Total treatment failure, if we see there is a P of value was significant, which is favoring the experimental arm. And if we see the distant mets, it's also hazard ratio is 0.69 and P value is significant, which is also favoring the experimental arm. And local failure, it's not a P value significant, but little bit of closer to that. Overall survival after median follow-up of 4.6, no difference in overall survival was observed, but might be revealed after longer follow-up that will continue until the 10 year after randomization according to trial protocol. Surgical outcome, if we see there is a significant values and is disease related local, regional and distant mets all are favoring the total TME, matlab before total surgery is done, before the total chemotherapy and radiotherapy is given. Watch and wait policy was also allowed. An adverse event, what are the adverse events? It's diarrhea, neurological defect, wound related events, which was equal in the both arms. And if we see the summary of the results, 7% local disease related treatment failure, 7% local distant mets rates, doubling in the pathology complete response, similar 3-year overall survival in no unexpected toxicity. Now about discussion, there is a rapido trial, the shorter duration of chemotherapy, 4 week of chemotherapy could also have contributed to the better compliance in the experimental group as compared to the standard care group, but did not result in reduced efficacy. That is proved by the Scott trial. That is, they have given the 3 month of FOLFOX and versus 6 month of FOLFOX. Another trial, POLIS phase 3 randomized trial, that has given the all chemoradiation, long course versus short course, there is no difference. The STELLAR trials, which also shows there is a higher complete response rate in the patient with short course radiotherapy followed by chemotherapy, was stable with increasing cases. Now if we see timing of chemotherapy, PORTGUIDE 23 trials, which is shown by the long course chemotherapy, radiotherapy followed by surgery and CAPOX, and then versus the another arm, total neoadjuvant. They have also shown the significant results. If we see the STOCKHOLM's 3 trials, they have shown the pathological complete response in 23 patients respectively. Surgical time, we see there is a longer waiting period, may be associated with higher morbidity and more difficulty surgical resection. What we learned from this, the standard treatment is not a standard of care. Chemotherapy before surgery or after or before chemoradiotherapy. Some patients can be observed for organ preservation approach if complete response by clinical radiological. Oxyplatin adds some benefits. Limit of the study, phase 3 randomized trial, good patient population, multicentric, and there is an absence of the central review of the baseline MRI, alteration of the primary endpoint during a trial is undesirable, chemotherapy is not similar in both arm, no randomized radiotherapy techniques, overall survival at 3 years, not all patients in standard arm receive the adjuvant chemotherapy. To conclude, I rapido trials of the short course radiotherapy followed by 18 weeks of chemotherapy before surgery decreases the probability of disease related treatment failure in the high risk locally advanced rectal cancer, reducing the probability of distant metastasis. High rate of pathology complete response, organ preservation, high compliance and tolerability. Hence, this treatment could be considered as a new standard of care for patients with high risk locally advanced rectal cancer. Thank you.